Hello, everybody. I'm David Jones-Gilardi, your friendly developer relations engineer. Today, I want to show you how to do true calling with agents using Ollama. Now, some of you might be wondering, why use Ollama? What's it used for? Well, Ollama allows you to run models locally off your own machine. So imagine for a moment, you maybe don't want to share your data with OpenAI or Anthropic or one of the public internet based providers, right? We see this question a lot. We see a lot of people who are asking, is there a way that I know that I can run models securely? And this is a really great way to do it. In this particular case, I'm going to use Alibaba's Qwen 2.5. I find it makes a really nice local model for tool calling and using with agents. Okay, so to do that, all you have to do is go up here to models and then tools. You definitely want to choose the ones that have tool calling available or they're not going to work quite right. And you see there's other options, but here's Qwen 2.5. Now, something I love about Ollama is how easy it is then to install the models and get going, right? So you can see here, I have all sorts of options that I could choose, but I'm gonna stick with that default of 7 billion parameters at 4.7 gigs. That's about right for my local machine because anything too big, it's gonna run pretty slow on my hardware. So I wanna kind of take them middle of the road. So all I have to do is copy this command, paste it into my terminal and go. And now it's going to download, in this case, the 4.7 gigabyte model. And then once this finishes up, we'll go ahead and start working with it. Okay, great. Now it's installed. You can actually chat with them here in the terminal, but I'm not going to do that right now. And then you see if I have my list, I now have Qwen 2.5 latest. So let's go ahead and start working with it in Langflow. Here I am in Langflow. And again, if you're not familiar with Langflow, go to langflow.org. You can take a look at the GitHub repository. It is a visual IDE that allows you to, you know, in a low-code, no-code way, build out GenAI flows. And so what we're going to do here is I'm just going to say new flow. I'm going to pick the simple agent, right? Because we want to figure out how to use Ollama with agents. All right, let me just set up a couple things. What I want to do is I want to just minimize these guys because they're not really the focus of what we're working at. Okay, so for the normal agent setup, we default to OpenAI, GPT-40 Mini. I'm gonna go ahead and set my key real quick. And then I have two tools, a URL tool and a calculator tool. So these tools will be available for my agent to use. Now, in this case, we've asked, the whole point of this video, right, is to show how to do this with Ollama, but I just kind of wanna set that everything is in play, right? So I'm gonna say my convert 200 USD to INR, right? So now if this all works the way I would expect it to do something like this where it's going out and fetching the content. And yeah, that is the correct value right now. And I could tell that it went out, got the latest exchange rate, and then calculated my answer. Okay, that's great. So now what I want to do though, is I want to convert this from OpenAI to Ollama. How do I do it? Super simple. All right, let's check it out. I'm just going to move this over. I'm going to make some room because I know something's coming, right? Now you'll notice here in the model provider list, there are a set of various providers that you can use, and then there's one here that is custom. I want custom, okay? So I'm gonna choose that custom one. I can get rid of this. Now, you'll notice that the menu collapsed down and it gave me this language model. If I click on that language model node, it's essentially saying, hey, bring in another language model. So I can drag Ollama over, which I'm gonna do. I'm gonna move some things around. Okay, we'll do like that. And notice this language model node here. So I can wire those up. Now, I'm close, but I'm not quite done. But I am saying now that for my agent LLM, I do in fact want to use Ollama. But notice that my model name dropdown is empty. I need to come over here and I need to refresh that. Now, in order for this to work, you see how it populated my base URL and then the model name's exposed. In order for that to work, I do need to have Ollama running locally. So if you are not familiar with Ollama, if you haven't used it yet, just go to ollama.com. And you can download it. It takes about 5 minutes. It's a super slick, fast, easy service. And then you go and you find the models that you're looking for. In this particular case, you're gonna want ones that have tool calling, all right? And that's gonna be very important. And as a matter of fact, if you come back over here to Langflow, you'll notice that the models that I have, look at the model list I have right now. Notice this little radio button right here, tool mode enabled. I'm gonna click that on. Now notice my model list is different. So what's happening under the hood is you need to ensure that if you want to use an Ollama-based model with your agent, right, that it needs to have tool calling supported or it will not work well, right? So make sure you flip that on. This is actually a new feature that was added to kind of make it very quick for you to filter on those. And then it will automatically filter the models that you have installed for those that have tool calling. I'll go ahead and pick Qwen here, 2.5. I've actually found that Qwen 2.5 for my local operations on like my local laptop does a really nice job of things. Okay, so I'm gonna use Qwen 2.5. Let's go ahead and run that query. I'm gonna do it in a different session, by the way, than the OpenAI one, because I don't want them to use each other's memory. Okay, let's see what it does here. Now, you notice here, you'll see that it's fetching the context, the URL fetch context text, which means it's using the URL tools, what it's doing. Now, one other thing to kind of point out is that sometimes when you run models locally, they may run longer. It may take longer to do, right? Especially if they are larger, higher parameter models or something, unless you have specialized hardware or something, just expect that. The good thing about it is that models like Qwen 2.5, I want to say, Llama 3.2.1b, right, are kind of optimized for running on smaller machines. But here we see that I actually get the correct result. That's good. Now, something to point out is that that may not always happen. When you are experimenting with these models, sometimes you have to be more explicit. You may actually have to tell something like, use the web to, you know, find the latest exchange rates. Now, in this case, Qwen 2.5 did that right off the bat, but it didn't always, right? It doesn't always do that. So just like you would with even models that you're using online and stuff like that, sometimes not only do you have to experiment with the type of input, kind of giving them a little nudge, but then also their temperature, right? It starts off right now, the default of 0.10. It's pretty conservative. You know, on the precise end, sometimes you want to bring it up a bit and give the model a little bit more leeway. And finally, once you have your Ollama agent set up, you can use the API to hook up your application and self-host wherever you want with all the privacy you need. So there you have it. That's all you need to do to use local models with Ollama and your agents. With that, everybody, happy coding. Take care.